Deep cover, deep cover. You want the music in the news, we got it covered.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Deep cover, deep cover. Entertainment starts here, this what they want. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What it is?
Trip.
What it is? How y'all feel?
In the building.
How y'all feel?
Finally here. Finally here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Y'all good?
Y'all good?
Yeah, great. Yeah. Blessed. How y'all feel?
Y'all
can't
nervous?
Complain, man.
Nah, I'm cool. I'm tired. I ain't gonna lie. What is it like?
She called y'all last night?
It's like 3 o'clock. Nah, but we stay in the studio till like 4 or 5 in the morning. So I wake up at 3 o'clock. That's early for me.
Yeah,
it's like
I was up early.
10, 9 a.m.
Right before I came here, I couldn't come here looking all dusty with the lint in the dreads.
With the lint in the dreads. Right, for sure. Now, over the holiday weekend, we met up with y'all.
Right.
You know, for the give back, the first annual give back. It was dope.
Drive, yeah.
Yes, it was so dope.
I ain't gonna lie, the turkeys was gone. The turkeys was gone when I pulled up.
Right.
What was I doing?
D-Day was you was like you had to go back in the house to get a shirt.
Oh yeah,
I can't pull up. I gotta go get a shirt.
Cause I had
I gotta go get a shirt. Hold
I had to go do something. Point, huh?
Like we about to be out here in sweats passing out turkeys. Eating.
I had on a tank top and a hoodie. I'm like, man,
first
I gotta go
all,
get
that
a shirt.
Was the first mistake coming out the house in November with a tank top and a hoodie.
Wait a minute.
It was a rut. I told you I don't wake up till like 3. I had something to do at like 10 in the morning. I just threw on a hoodie.
This was scheduled. He knew this was happening.
Yeah. For quite
it's not
some
like
time.
It popped up out of nowhere.
Hey.
Get I know we got there at 1:30 and the tickets was gone.
Yeah. And it started at 1.
Yeah. They was passing them out before it was even time to start.
It was like 12 o'clock.
And people was hungry. It was like, you want some turkey?
I heard, what was it, 2 hours they was lined up before?
Yeah.
Shout out to y'all.
Now, how did that make y'all feel, though, actually giving back to the community in Baltimore?
I mean, it made me feel good. I always like giving back. I'm a generous person by nature, so I just love helping people regardless of what I'm doing or who I'm doing it for.
Okay.
Right.
I wish I would have made it on time. It would have made me feel good. I felt good coming.
You ain't seen no turkeys either?
Oh, man.
You just like us then. We ain't seen no turkeys either. We got there 2 days.
I ain't seen nothing. Nothing. I pulled up. Everything was gone. I showed face, though. Talked to a lot of people, so.
Yeah, you did.
I always try to, you know, I'm 20, so I can't really go to, like, a lot of events. I could, but I just don't like playing the dual games.
You 20
and
all. Right. When, though?
Yeah, my birthday Wednesday. Shout out.
Wow, 21.
D-Day with the game.
D-Day
I'm out of there. Get out of here. Yeah. We going to the horseshoe.
Yeah.
You feel me? At midnight. Meet us there at midnight. I'm not playing.
Yeah. Just
look, you got to get me 20, though. You meet me there. Give me 20. I'm spending everything in horseshoe.
Everything.
Then I got a flight to Miami. I'm getting out of there.
Okay. Good play.
You spend too much time in the horseshoe. You ain't going to make it to Miami.
Listen, I might stay in there till my flight. Honestly.
Oh, okay.
I ain't going with you.
That's
bad.
How you starting off?
Listen,
like, that's
X-Trip,
like,
I spend.
He's a real spender.
I spend.
The real spender.
Take too long.
And a rubbed off on my little bit.
I spend. Y'all just don't see it.
That was going to take me to my next question, because Trip, how old are you?
22.
Yeah. Like, I mean, y'all young.
Yeah.
Like, what made you even want to get into the entertainment music industry?
I mean, I started doing this when I was like 13, 14. I always liked writing stuff. I always felt like I could rap. I never was just confident enough to do it till I let somebody hear it. Then once that happened, everybody just kept telling me to keep going with it, that I had something special. So I'm like, all right, everybody said I got it. I'm going to keep doing it.
All right, for sure.
With me, I had a bro in high school, my bro Jay Leon. He was making beats. So we was in, what was that, English class? He used to show me his beats, and I used to just, like, brush them off. Like, man, everybody say they do music. I don't care.
Right.
But they was different. Like, they was different. So then when I used to, like, mess with DJing, but I never, like, thought about doing it serious. So then the day after we graduated, he moved. So this was, like, my best friend 12th grade. The day after we graduated, he moved. So I was just like, dang, I don't got nobody to mess with the music with.
Right.
I was just like, I just text him, like, I'm about to, like, try making beats. I just tried it, so it's been like 4 years for me. I always loved beats, though. I remember I used to buy all the Dr. Dre albums, instrument. Like, I still got them on my phone, the Chronic 2001 instrumental albums, no lyrics. Like, I just used to buy instrumentals and listen to them. So I always loved beats. I just never, like, knew.
No Dr. Dre son, for real.
I never thought to make my own. I just like listening to beats. So then when I figured out that
That's
you can make
DJ
your own
stand
beats.
For Dr. Dre Jr.
Yeah. Dr. Dre need to cut me a check. Like, no, tell so, Dr. Dre co-sign me.
Yeah. And y'all process, like, who or what is y'all daddy motivation to get y'all going and get y'all want to make raps just like on the
why
make,
do you
make
do it?
And stuff?
Why do you
everyday
keep
life,
doing?
For real. Like, it's my experiences. It's just, I'm one of them people, I don't like rapping. I never rap about anything that I don't do or see myself or have experienced. So, all my music comes from life experience.
You know, you know, with that fake stuff.
No, sir. I uphold honesty to the highest degree.
Right. Okay.
I don't like lies.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, me, usually, just saying it, just traveling. So, like, when I started, I was just blessed to be around the right people. So, I got to see a lot, like, during my first year. So, seeing all that, being around millionaires, traveling, catching flights, 16, 17 by myself, I was like, man, this... I ain't gotta do nothing else. I can live off of this. It's cool.
Yeah, that's the life.
So seeing that, it's like, I know it's possible because I done did it already at 16, 17, 18. Right. I'm only 20. I got forever, really. Yeah. So
young in the game.
Yeah.
Definitely young in the game. But speaking of life, like, how was life growing up in Baltimore for both of you?
Man, let me tell you. Look, I ain't gonna lie. I probably give y'all a different side because I ain't from the city. I'm from Woodlawn right here. So it was like it's West Side Line, but it was cool. Like I ain't really like I don't know. And then we moved like the Orange Mills area. So like my family, it ain't a big house, but it's like a decent sized house. But everybody see it and be like, oh, y'all rich? Nah, like it ain't like that. Right? My peoples did the right thing. Like, my people smart, so they did the right things and made the right choices to be able to get the type of house that they wanted. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
So, like, it wasn't never like I struggled or nothing. Like, my life was cool. It's like everything that I did on my own. So, like, everything that I ended up getting into when I was old, really, like, when I graduated early. I graduated at 16. So, as soon as I graduated. I wasn't even like, I just graduated early because I hate school, honestly. I was trying to get it done.
Wait,
so.
You graduated early because you hate school.
I was trying to get it done.
I was trying to do the same thing. I was trying to get out of there.
Well, hopefully my son hates school so he can graduate.
Yeah. So you just like flew by. You just applied. Because not hard. You applied.
So listen, my mother's a teacher, right?
Sitting in class, man.
So my mother's a teacher. I'm smart. I used to be in GT and all that. I got kicked out for my behavior. So then we get to ninth grade. I'm doing terrible. I almost failed ninth grade completely. Had to go to summer school, all that. So then I'm like, man, I'm trying to get out of here. I'm not trying to fail. 10th grade, straight A's and B's. I had all my credits already because I was in GT, so I was taking the classes in middle school. So then my 10th grade year, I just went to my guidance. I was like, man, I'm trying to graduate early. It was like, you got all the credits? I'm like, yeah. They was like, all right. Write a little letter to the principal. Literally on my letter, I wrote, I'm trying to graduate early because I told him if I come for 12th grade year, I'm going to fail. I'm like, I'm not taking a whole... seven class day of electives. I'm gonna fail. I'm not gonna try. It's gonna bring my GPA down, and I'm not waking up for two classes. So just give me the two classes that I need in this 11th grade year. So they literally, the guidance counselor ain't even give it to the principal. She read it. She was like, wow, I'm gonna just approve it. I'm like, all right, boom. I'm 15 in 12th grade. Swear. Graduated at 16. So I just got it done like that. So, but after I graduated, that's when I just started like, you know, I'm impulsive. I ain't gonna lie. And I've been having money. So, like, went and bought a motorcycle. I had a car. Okay. I was just doing whatever. Like,
he was dragging.
Whatever. I was just doing it because it was like, it wasn't nothing else to do. I was too young to go to college.
Ain't nothing else to do.
Wasn't nothing else to do, literally. So, it was like, all right, what else can I do? So, I just started doing whatever I wanted. And that's why I kind of fell into the music. I had enough money to pay for studio time. So, I was in the studio every day. Started meeting people.
How did y'all meet? Like, cause
K-Dot.
Yeah, my little brother Pyrex, K-Dot. Pyrex turned me up.
Pyrex turned me up.
They used to be together every day. We used to go over Pyrex house at their apartment. He had an apartment out Woodlawn. Yeah. We used to go over there till we got kicked out.
Yo, his neighbors hate, especially the lady upstairs. Oh, she got stand up. She used to be stomping on the floor
every day,
knocking on the door, turn that music down. I'm too loud.
Every
middle
single
of the day, like, yo, go somewhere. Why you in the house? Go somewhere. So
Trip, as far as you, how was for you growing up in Baltimore?
I have a somewhat similar story to D-Day. Like, I never really was, I wasn't born in no trenches. I'm from the county, feel me? From Randallstown, Woodlawn, Milford, Windsor Mill, that whole area. So I never really wanted for too much when I was growing up, but everybody got their problems that they face when they going through stuff. And a lot of the stuff, like he said, feel me, a lot of my problems that happened to me, I brought on to myself just being young and dumb, you feel me, making stupid decisions, being impulsive, doing things that I knew I had no business doing, but I was intrigued with it, so I was like, man, I'm going to go ahead and do it, because it was foreign to me. It's not what I grew up seeing or being around, so once I started seeing certain things, I started just jumping into certain lifestyles that I knew wasn't going to be good for me, but feel me, right. I did good in school. I was a good kid. I wasn't like D-Day. I was well-behaved in school. I was always a good kid in school, for real. Okay. My grades were straight. I was in GTA, AP classes, nice. All that. I was trying to graduate early, but they weren't trying to let me go, so I was like, all right, then I'm not going to have no classes my senior year. So senior year, I would just go to school for like 1-2 classes. I'd be late anyway, so I'd be there for like an hour, leave school and just go do something for the rest of the day, go work or something like that. I started working at a young age too. As soon as I was able to, I started working. So I've been working my whole life. But yeah, like once at the high school, went to college for a year out in PA, went to Penn State.
Okay.
Needless to say, that did not turn out good. It was fun.
I ain't gonna lie. I ain't even know Tripp went to college.
I don't even know. You learn something new every day.
No, I found out probably like 2 years later, because he used to be like, yeah, when I was at school, I'm like, what school, boy? We've been out of school for like 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
Like, I went to Penn State. Like, boy, what you went for? A semester?
Yeah.
A semester? Two semesters.
Yeah,
two semesters.
Got two under your belt.
It was cool. It was a good experience. I mean, I got to see what life was like outside of Maryland, because other than going on like vacations and stuff with my family, like I hadn't really been outside of Maryland to like experience nothing on my own. Feel me? Messed up in school, came back home, started working again, feel me? Started grinding. And I was like, man, I ain't got nothing else going for me right now but this music. This is the strongest thing I have in my life, and it's the only thing I've been holding on to. So I just kept pushing that after I came back. And now I'm here.
Now you here. Now we got that control.
Yeah.
DJ.
Control. Yeah. My little man Nas made the beat. Shout out to Nas.
He
in here with us.
Got my man Frankie G on here. Make sure y'all look both of them.
Look,
got a lot of fans in the world.
Listen, collage coming strong. I promise y'all.
I feel it.
We did the collage tape last year, but... This
ain't nothing compared to this shit.
Because I'm about to drop a project.
Let's get to this control. Let's get to this control. Let them hear this real quick. Yes.
Let them hear that.
Make sure you keep it locked. It's deep cover.
Slow up. The way I beat it, she gon' need it. Slow up. But I control her, baby.
See? Yeah.
That's lit. Y'all so lit.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Like, for real. That's dropping on Wednesday. We got the exclusive.
Yeah, y'all really got the exclusive. Yeah. I had to make it. Look, I don't even rap. Just because
I
can.
Know, right?
Y'all really got that exclusive.
Because I can. Yes. We got a caller, though, on air.
Oh, man.
Caller, you on air.
Who is this? What's up?
Go ahead.
Y'all ready for me?
What it is. Make sure
that... What's up?
Hold on before you start speaking, just respect the mic. No profanity and no N-word. Now continue. Who are we speaking with?
What's up? My name Lando.
What it do, shorty? What it do, man? What's up with you, Lando?
I got three quick things I want to say, man.
What's up?
Man, I'm listening in, man. Shout out to D-Day, man. You gifted. You're a gifted producer, engineer. You know I support you all the way.
Yeah.
You know I'm waiting for that tape Wednesday, too, boy.
Yeah, yeah, it's coming. Appreciate it.
Shout out to Trip. Shout out to Trip, too, man. Yo, you in your lane, yo. You do your own thing. You different, yo. I respect that.
Hey,
you feel
man.
What I'm saying?
I appreciate that.
You know, I ride
that.
With you all the way.
Already,
shout out, I don't know if Tego Bang still in there, but shout out to Tego Bang. He rapping that North, man. I'm Northeast forever, man. So shout out to Tego Bang for that.
Coming
yeah,
out.
That's all I had to say.
It's my man, day one. Went to high school with me. He used to come to class every day. Look, funniest dude ever, man.
Lando,
I swear.
Lando, my dude.
He got on my nerves.
Solid dude, though,
my man.
Now, D-Day, I gotta like ask you this question, because I heard you, you know, well, I didn't hear you, but I saw on Instagram, you know.
Oh, Lord.
You made this post. I just gotta ask you, what's the difference between a beat maker and a producer?
Here we go.
Because you had a lot to say.
Here we go. All right, because look, Oh, by the way, can we throw out this phone number real quick? Somebody just asked me the phone number.
410-481-1010.
All right.
410-481-1010. Give us a call. All
right. So, a beat maker is somebody that just sit at home in front of their computer
make 10 beats all day, send them off, just send them in the email, and that's it, and just wait, and just they just on the computer, that's it, they just sending out beats, waiting for somebody to write them back, they on Twitter, just on Instagram, like you just not there in person, whereas a producer, you're gonna be in the studio, you're gonna build with an artist, you're gonna build relationships with them.
Right.
You might sit there and make a beat with them, for them, whatever. You're gonna help construct the song, like how me and Tay got to where we got, like Famous, for example. Famous is a perfect example.
Yeah.
He called me and said, yo, I got this idea for a hook. I need a beat to it, and he rapped it to me. So I said, all right, bet. So when I got to the studio, but I be so busy, like I can't do so much.
Mm-hmm.
But as soon as I get like a little chance, I'm gonna do it. So he was coming to the studio. It was probably like 10 minutes before. Sat there, started making a beat. I just had the piano real quick. So he came in, he started humming to it. I'm like, oh, you like this? Like that? Don't like that? Whatever. Take this out, add this. Made the beat real quick. Like sit there and construct the whole song with him. So it goes from my computer, from his input and my input, coming together, then I export the MP3, load it into Pro Tools, then I engineer it too, so now I'm recording it. Now he say something like that, yeah, we faint. Yeah. He wasn't about to keep that. He was just trying to figure out his words. I'm like, yo, that's hard, keep it.
Dang.
He was like, nah. I'm like, nah, that's it. Like, that's it. You don't gotta say nothing. That works.
Right.
So that's the difference. Like, a producer's actually gonna help you construct a whole song and just be there hands on with you. Like, I travel with my artists everywhere, like shows, whatever. I do sound checks, all of that. Beat makers, they ain't nothing wrong with being a beat maker. It's just if you're a beat maker, just do that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, don't try to
don't call yourself no producer.
Yeah, don't get mad when you get overlooked because you're not doing what we're doing. You might make a hard beat and send it off. That's cool.
You can't
but you
get
didn't,
mad when you don't, you don't,
yeah, you
don't
didn't,
get the
you didn't input
you didn't
on this.
Go to get it yourself.
Yeah, you didn't actually have no hands-on input in creating this record. So that's just
and another note. Y'all trying to say you're on another level.
Correct.
Oh, definitely.
Bass.
Kalon is on another level.
On another level.
Y'all
got the phone
lines
jumping.
Right.
What's up? Who it is?
Hello,
call you on there?
I guarantee it's K-Dot.
It probably is.
Yeah, you feel me?
Yeah, he comes straight in.
Yeah, you feel me?
What's
up, Dobby? I love y'all, Dobby.
Hey, look, I see you on Wednesday. He going to Miami with me if he don't love.
Yeah, they just going.
Can we go too?
Look, come on. Nah, I told you. Look,
be they with the game?
D-Day with the game? Banger.
They leaving me here in Baltimore. They flying down to good Miami with that good weather, leaving me in here.
They going
to
leave you here?
Yeah, they leave
us here. That's messed up. You're not with the game. You're not with the game.
Definitely not a whole lot of game.
Hey, I got excited because Tripp left me when he went to Vegas. So it's alright.
Don't let him tell that lie. I told everybody months in advance about that Vegas trip.
I was 20. I couldn't go.
We just started something.
How's it
now?
My fault? We did.
I'm sorry, y'all. All right, we're gonna wrap it up though. We're gonna talk about this off air. Let everybody know where they can find y'all at on all social media.
Man, you can find me all social media. It's KingTripp410. That's Twitter, SoundCloud, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, any type of anything. Just search KingTripp410. You will find me.
Yes.
All right, mine, D-Day Collage, or D-Day _ Collage, KOLLAGE. It's not Killage.
Yes,
it's not college.
Right. I be getting so tired of correcting
people. What did they say? What? How they